Hi everybody, this is Indira, Assistant Professor of Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Department of Mathematics. Today, we would like to start the third module, that is functions of several variables in linear algebra and calculus. Already, we have seen two modules on matrices, and this is the third module, which is on functions of several variables. In this, we have two parts. The first part, we would like to know the mean value theorems. In the second part, the partial derivatives and finding out the maxima and minima for more than one variable, that is two and three variables. So, in mean value theorems, we have three different mean value theorems discussed in this module. That is, first is Rolle's mean value theorem, second is Lagrange's mean value theorem, third is Cauchy's mean value theorem. In the second part, we would like to find how to find the partial derivatives of the given function. Then we will go for the Jacobian transformation. Next, maxima and minima of functions of two variables, and there, and again the maxima and minima of functions of three variables. And at last, the method of Lagrange's multipliers, which is also the method to find out maxima and minima of functions of several variables. Starting with the mean value theorems, we would like to start with the Rolle's mean value theorems. And before going to the mean value theorems, let us understand where it is applicable. Then we will go for the what is the Rolle's mean value theorem, what is Cauchy's and Lagrange's mean value theorems. These mean value theorems helps to find out whether the function has a solution or not. To find out the solution of the given function, first we have to discuss what is the when the function is continuous or not. Next, whether the function is derivable or not. If a given function holds this, then the given function is applicable for Rolle's or Lagrange's or Cauchy's mean value theorems. Going to the first mean value theorem, that is Rolle's mean value theorem. Here it says that let f of x be a function such that it is continuous in the closed interval a comma b, and it is differentiable in open interval a comma b. The third point, that the two functions are at the same height, that is f of a is equal to f of b. If a function holds all these three conditions, then it is eligible for applying the mean value theorem. According to the Rolle's mean value theorem, if these three conditions are satisfied, then the f dash of c is equal to 0, where c is a point in between the interval a comma b. So now we will like to discuss what is mean by the continuity of a function, when a function is to be differentiable, and then how to understand that f of a is equal to f of b for the given curve. Geometrically, if you see that f continuous means that the function never breaks with either at any point. Suppose you have f of x is equal to f of x is equal to 1 by x. 1 by x. If x is equal to minus 1, then f of x will be equal to minus 1. So, the coordinate here is minus 1, comma minus 1. Similarly, if you go for x is equal to 1, then f of x is equal to 1 by 1, that is equal to 1. Therefore, the coordinates here, the paired up is 1, comma 1. And in between these two, if you take x is equal to 0, then f of x is equal to infinity. There, the coordinate pair is 0, comma infinity. When you plot a graph between x and y, we can plot the point 1, minus 1, comma 1. We can plot even the point 1, comma 1. But we can't plot the point 0, comma infinity. there the curve breaks. So the continuity of a function in the sense at each and every point of x, y should be the y value, that is y is equal to f of x, y value should be finite value. It should not be any infinite values, even the imaginary value also, right? Okay, so sometimes if you take, suppose y is equal to 1 by, suppose if I take some other curve, y is equal to 1 by root x. Now, at x is equal to 0, we can't plot the graph. So, the y is equal to 1 by x, 1 by root x is discontinuous function at x is equal to 0. Even at the when x value is negative, then root of the negative value is imaginary. If you plot the graph in the real plane, it doesn't know where to put the y values. So, in that case, even y by root x is also a discontinuous function. So, we can just judge ourselves whether the function is continuous or not just by looking at the y values by randomly taking some x values. So, if at any one point the function is not giving any infinite values, then the function is said to be discontinuous function. Otherwise, it is always a continuous function. Here, the square brackets of a comma b says that a and b, both boundary values are, the boundary points are also included, and it represents the closed interval. And the bracket a comma b like this, it represents the open interval, that is excluding a comma b. That means we have infinite number of, we can take infinite number of points at the neighborhood of a comma b. So here we are going to discuss the continuity of the given function in the closed interval, and we are going to check the differentiability of the given function in the open interval. So that is the main thing that we have to put into the concentration while discussing the mean value theorems in any interval for any function. Now, going to the differentiability of the function, how to understand the differentiability of the function, and this concept is unique for whatever mean value theorems you are applying. All mean value theorem, the first condition is the function should be continuous, and the second thing, the function should be differentiable in whatever open interval that you are taking. Now, going to the second point, that is nothing but differentiability. Suppose if I take y is equal to x square, then y dash, okay, and we are representing y is nothing but f of x here. Now, the derivative of the function f dash of x is equal to 2x. To our knowledge, x square is a polynomial equation which gives a finite point whatever value of x you take. So, therefore, y is equal to x square is always continuous. And going to the differentiability of the function, the derivative of y, that is x square, is nothing but 2x, and for whatever value you substitute in place of x, whether it may be a complex number or a real number, it may be a zero, f dash of x definitely exists. Existence means after substituting x value does not give any indeterminate value or infinite values. So as long as it is not giving any infinite values or indeterminate values, the derivative of the function is always said to be existed. So, here the example that I have taken, y is equal to x square, is always differentiable function. So, the first two properties of mean value theorem holds here. So, y is equal to x square is capable of applying the mean value theorems. So, in that way we are going to understand the continuity and differentiability of the function in closed and the open intervals. Now, going to the third point of the Rolle's theorem, it says that the third condition that the function should hold is f of a should be equal to f of b. What does it mean? Suppose if I take any curve, f of x, y is equal to f of x, then it says that the two endpoints, wherever I am discussing, the two endpoints should lie with at the same height with the x-axis. And this point, suppose if it is a, and that another edge of the function, let us suppose that I represent it by b, then a is nothing but a comma f of a, and b is nothing but b comma f of b. And here a and b are lying at the same, on the same height. So therefore, you can say that the third condition of the Rolle's mean value theorem is also satisfied. So it says that whenever a function is continuous in a closed interval a comma b and differentiable in the open interval a comma b, and the two end points of the given function or the given curve lies on the same height, or else they both are equal, then there exists at least one point C in the closed interval a comma b such that f dash of c is equal to 0. That means that the solution of the function, it definitely exists between the a comma. What do you mean by the solution of the function? It is a value of x where the function reduces to 0. So here we are going to search for the value of the function f of x between a comma b where the function is reduced to 0. That means we are going to find out the solution of the given function. Now, after satisfying the continuity and differentiability and the function has the same height, then I've said that there exists some point C belongs to open interval a comma b such that f dash of C is equal to 0. It says that there exists a point on a comma b where the tangent at that point is parallel to x-axis. The tangent at that point, f dash of C represents the slope. F dash of x represents the slope of the given curve. That means at how it is increasing, how it is decreasing, and what is the angle of the given curve with the x-axis. That all nothing but the slope of the given curve. So f dash of c represents the slope of the given tangent. If that given tangent is parallel to x-axis, at that point f dash of c is equal to 0. So that is how the Rolle's mean value theorem is applicable. So definitely, once again, to apply the Rolle's mean value theorem to know the increasing and decreasing orders of a given function, we applied the Rolle's mean value theorems or Lagrange's mean value theorem or Cauchy's mean value theorem according to the number of the functions that we have. Suppose if you have only single function, then in order to apply the Rolle's mean value theorem, first we have to check whether it is continuous. Secondly, we have to show that it is differentiable. If these two conditions are satisfied, third condition should satisfy, that is the end of the given function should lie on the same height with the x-axis. Then there exists a point in between. Definitely there exists a point in between a comma b where the function is reduces to 0. So in this model also, the geometrical interpretation of the Rolle's mean value theorem can be done. Now I have taken some other curve on x and y axis, and we can have that the tangent points are many, more than one. There are three tangent points on the curve where the tangent is parallel to x-axis. That means that that type of function touches the x-axis again and again. That means that that type of a function have a solution more than one. So if the curve that has many number of times the curve touches the x-axis, that many number of solutions we can expect for the given function. So that is about the Rolle's mean value theorem definition. Now we will go for the geometrical interpretation of the Rolle's mean value theorem. Let f be a function from a comma b to a real number, be a function satisfying the three conditions of the Rolle's theorem. Then I have two graphs. And in the two graphs, I have given one tangent point which is parallel to x-axis. That means that the given function y is equal to f of x is continuous curve on closed interval a comma b, and there exists a unique tangent line here. I could see the tangent line which is parallel to x-axis. Tangent line at every point x is equal to c, where c lies between a comma b. The ordinates f of b, f of a, f of b and f of a at the end points capital A and b are equal, so that the points A and B are equidistant from x-axis. In other words, we can call like that. Okay, by Rolle's mean value theorem, there exists one point x is equal to c between A, small a, and B on the curve at which the tangent line is parallel to x-axis. Also, it is parallel to the chord of the given curve. Even the chord of the given curve also, you can see the parallelization of the tangent with the chord or to the x-axis. So that is how we can understand the geometrical interpretation of Rolle's theorem. Now, going to the problems based on the Rolle's mean value theorem, we would expect two types of problems are there. In first model of problems, we would like to verify the Rolle's mean value theorem. And the second model of the problems, we are going to use the Rolle's mean value theorem. Okay, in both the cases, a student is needed to check the continuity of the given function and differentiability of the given function. And the third condition, the end points f of a, wherever you are taking the interval points, at the two end points of the interval, the function should have the same value. Then the Rolle's mean value theorem is applicable. Now I have taken one simple example. Verify Rolle's theorem for the function f of x is equal to sin x by e power x, or you can even write this as e power minus x into sin x, and in the closed interval 0 comma pi. So as we have discussed in the previous slide, that in order to apply or verify the Rolle's theorem, the first condition, the continuity, has to be satisfied. Here the function f of x is sin x by e power x. Here the function is sin x by e power x. We all know that the sin x, the trigonometrical function sin x or cos x, are always continuous. That means if you see the graph of sin x, it is continuous. If you go for tan x at x is equal to pi by 2, the curve goes to infinity. So we don't have any discontinuous points in the sin x or cos x in whatever interval you take. So sin x is always continuous function. The second one, e power x, the exponential functions are always continuous. You can see that the e power x is 1 plus x square by 2 factorial plus x 3 x to the power 3 factorial, so on up till infinity. So it is the curve at which can be described, which gives a finite point at each and every point. So e power x is also a continuous function. So sin x is a continuous, e power x is continuous. The division of the two continuous points is always continuous. Therefore, f of x, which is equal to sin x by e power x, is also continuous. So in that way, we can justify that the function is always continuous. Now going to the differentiability of the given function. Now, the derivative of sin x is nothing but cos x, and derivative of e power x is again e power x. The division, and which are both a differentiable function. That means we don't have any infinite points. If you choose any point x for sin x or cos x or e power x in f dash of x, then we don't get any infinite points. So as long as we are not getting any infinite points, f dash of x, which is nothing but the derivative value of sin x by cos x gives a finite value. So as long as it gives a finite value, the function is always said to be differentiable in the closed interval 0, pi. So in that way we can check the differentiability of the given function. Going to the third condition of the Rolle's mean value theorem. In the third condition, the interval he has given is 0, pi, and our a value, if you compare the given interval with a, b, a is equal to 0 and b is equal to pi. Let us substitute these values in the given function. The given function is f of x is equal to sin x by e power x. So you have, if you at x is equal to 0, then f of 0 is equal to, you can write this as sin 0 by e power 0. Sin 0 is 0 and e power 0 is 1, which is equal to 0. And again at x is equal to another limit point, if you take x is equal to pi, then f of pi is equal to sin pi by e power pi, and numerator sin pi is 0, so therefore the sin pi by e power pi is again 0. So therefore f of 0 is equal to f of pi. It means that the given function sin x by e power x has same functional value at both the ends of the given interval, closed interval. So therefore you can say that all the three conditions of Rolle's mean value theorem is satisfied. So we have checked the continuity of the given function, and we have checked the differentiability, and also we have calculated the functional value at both the endpoints 0 and pi, and we have showed that it is equal, both are equal. So if these three conditions are satisfied, then we will try to find out the value c, which lies between a, b, such that f dash of c is equal to 0. So that is the last part of the Rolle's theorem. So let us suppose that these three conditions are satisfied. Condition 1, 2 and 3 are satisfied. So there exists some c belongs to open interval 0, pi, such that f dash of c is equal to 0. So what is f dash of c? So again f of x is equal to sin x by e power x. So you go for f dash of x. F dash of x will be equal to f dash of x. I'll better write this as sin x into e power minus x. So I'll use u into v rule to find out the derivative of the given function. So sin x into e power minus x. Derivative of e power minus x is minus e power minus x, plus e power minus x is as it is derivative of sin x, which is nothing but cos x. Okay, cos x. Now I am assuming some value c between the open interval a, b, so such that f dash of c is equal to 0. So wherever x is there, you try to substitute c. So what you are going to get it as, better to take e power minus x as common. So e power minus c, okay, minus sin c plus cos c is equal to 0. You know that the exponential never become equal to 0. So therefore, you can say that sin c plus cos c is equal to 0. Implies that bring cos c on the other side, you will get it as sin c is equal to cos c. And sin c by cos c, and you can still write this as sin c by cos c is equal to 1. Okay, and sin c by cos c is nothing but the tan c. Tan c is equal to 0, and tan c is equal to 0 implies the c value, tan c is equal to 1, so implies that c is equal to 45 degrees, we will get the tan c gives 1, therefore c is equal to 45 degrees, and which is nothing but pi by 4, and it's sure that pi by 4 value lies between 0 and pi. So that's how the Rolle's mean value theorem can be verified. Hence the Rolle's mean value theorem is verified. This is how we have to give the a verification of the Rolle's mean value theorem. Each and every point has to be discussed while applying the mean value theorems. Okay, see, look here. Now, f dash of c is equal to cos c minus sin c, and I've got tan c is equal to 1, or c is equal to pi by 4, which belongs to the open interval 0 comma pi. Hence, the Rolle's theorem is verified. Now, going to the second example, verify Rolle's theorem for log of x square plus ab by x into a plus b in closed interval a comma b, where a is greater than 0 and b is greater than 0. So let f of x is equal to given function. What is a logarithmic function? You all know that the trigonometrical function, few trigonometrical functions, exponential functions and logarithmic functions are always continuous. There is no need for you to prove that they are continuous, right? But still, we will replace this log of x square plus ab by x into a plus b, as you all know that log of a by b is log of a minus log of b. So you can write this as log of, to make it the problem more flexible, we'll write this as log of x square plus ab minus log of x minus log of a plus b. So if we expand in this manner, it's very easy for us to check, verify the continuity and differentiability of this one, this type of rational logarithm, rational function. The first case, and I've said that the logarithmic functions are always continuous. Okay, so therefore the given function is continuous in the closed interval a comma b. Going to the differentiability of the given function, now you try to calculate the given f dash of c. So if f of x is equal to log of x square plus a b minus log of x minus log of a plus b, then what is f dash of x? F dash of x will be equal to 1 by log, derivative of log x is 1 by x. So 1 by log of x square plus ab into the internal differentiation, that is nothing but 2x minus log of x derivation is nothing but 1 by x, log of x derivation is nothing but 1 by x. Okay, minus the zero value, where if a and b are constant, the log of a plus b, the derivative of log of a plus b is 0. So the f dash of x is equal to, I got in this manner, and which is which can be written as, if I take this LCM, I mean you can write this as this is the derivative of 1 by x square plus ab. Okay, so this can be written as x into x square plus ab and x square minus ab, and which exists for all values of x, whatever values it you take for x value. Okay, so therefore if the f of x is differentiable function. The third point that we need to check whether the end points are all are same or not. The end points, what are the end points that we have to check at a and b? So let us substitute here, let us substitute x is equal to a and x is equal to b here. Okay, so if x is equal to a, then f of a is equal to log of a square plus ab by a into a plus b, and both are gets cancelled, log of 1 which is equal to 0. So which is equal to 0. So the lower point I got it as 0. Now I'll substitute with the higher point, that is maximum point, f of b. I'll try to calculate f of b. Okay, and remember that this is applicable if both f of a and f of b are equal, right? So wherever x is there, you put b. So b square plus ab by b into a plus b. Once again, both will get cancelled, giving log of 1. So log of 1 is again equal to 0. So you can infer that f of a is equal to f of b. That means that the function is of same height at a and b with the x-axis. So all the three properties of Rolle's mean value theorem is satisfied. So we can find the c value such that f dash of c is equal to there exists some c belongs to the open interval a comma b such that f dash of c is equal to 0. Now what is f dash of c? F dash of x is equal to x square minus ab by x into x square plus ab. So wherever x is there you put c here. So you are going to get that c minus ab by c into c square plus ab is equal to 0. So you start calculating the value of c square is equal to ab and c is equal to under root of ab, which represents the geometrical mean between a and the open interval a comma b. The geometrical mean or arithmetic mean always lies inside the interval, not outside the interval. So you can say that the c value lies belongs to the open interval a comma b. Therefore, hence the Rolle's mean value theorem is verified. So this is how we can able to verify the Rolle's theorem. Now the another example, we'll go for the next example. Verify whether the Rolle's theorem can be applicable to the following functions in the interval. f of x is equal to tan x in the interval 0 comma pi. Okay, you all know that in between 0 comma pi there exists a value where the function goes to infinity. That value is nothing but pi by 2. We all know that tan 90 degrees is infinity. So it is very clear that f of x which is equal to tan x is discontinuous function at x is equal to pi by 2. Therefore the mean value theorem is not applicable. If any one of the condition of the three condition is not satisfied, then we should not use the Rolle's mean value theorem, right? So the first problem, that is f of x is equal to tan x is discontinuous at 0 comma in the interval 0 comma, not always it is discontinuous. If you change the interval from pi some other interval where it is not it does not give any infinite values, then we can apply the mean value theorems. But I've taken the interval where we can find out one point where the function reduces to infinity. So therefore I can say that tan x is discontinuous function and mean value theorems are not applicable. Now going to the next problem, f of x is equal to 1 by x square in minus 1 comma 1. Okay, and in between the closed interval minus 1 comma 1 there exists a point 0 where 1 by x square gives 1 by 0. Okay, 1 by x square gives 1 by 0, which is nothing but infinity. So it is very clear that the function is discontinuous function at x is equal to 0. So the mean value theorem is cannot be applied. And going to the next one, verify the Rolle's theorem of the function f of x is equal to x minus a whole to the power of m, x minus b whole to the power of n, where m and n are positive integers in closed interval a comma b. Okay, now x minus a into x minus b is always a polynomial function. For a polynomial function or composite function, there is no need for us to check the continuity. They are always continuous. So the first point that the Rolle's mean value theorem has to for applying Rolle's mean value theorem, that is continuity, is satisfied for this function. Now going to the differentiability of the function. For the differentiability of the function, I would like to find out the derivative of the given function. Now the given function is a product of the two different variables, that is the two different terms, that is x minus a and x minus b. So I would like to use u into v rule. So f dash of x is equal to, you have the m into x minus a whole to the power of m minus 1, that is the derivative of x minus a whole to the power of m, and the other x minus b whole to the power of n is constant, plus the derivative of x minus b whole to the power of n, where x minus a whole to the power of m is constant. So if I do that, I'll get the product of triple product, that is x minus a whole to the power of m minus 1, x minus b whole to the power of n minus 1 into m plus n into minus mv plus na. Okay, so therefore the function is differentiable. Now let's check the end points, whether they are equal or not. Okay, you all know that f of a, if x is equal to a, then f of a is equal to 0. And similarly, if x is equal to b, then f of b is equal to 0, because you have x minus b. If I substitute x is equal to b, b minus b becomes 0. So there the product of, if one of the value is 0, definitely the product reduces to 0. So f of a, from these two you can infer that f of a is equal to f of b. So all the three conditions of mean value, the Rolle's mean value theorem is satisfied. Now I'll go to find out the value of c. So there exists some c belongs to the closed interval a comma b, closed interval a comma, I'm sorry, open interval a comma b, such that, because we have to check the point in the open interval, not in the closed interval, because the differentiability holds for the open interval. So the common of the closed in the open interval, we should take it as a open interval. So such that f dash of c is equal to 0. So f dash of c is equal to 0, I'll take this value. So we have that wherever x is there, you put c. So you can have that x is equal to, m plus n into x. X is nothing but c, okay, into mb plus na is equal to 0. So c is equal to mb plus na divided by m plus n, which is nothing but the internal division point. C is the internal division point of the interval a comma b, which lies inside the, in between the interval a and b. So therefore you can say that the Rolle's theorem is very fine. So this is how. So the mb plus na by m plus n is a internal division point of a comma b, right? Okay, so going to the next, now we'll take one problem where we can use the Rolle's mean value theorem. Usage of Rolle's mean value theorem also, in that also it is better to check the continuity, differentiability, then we'll make use of the third condition, f of a is equal to f of b. Okay, here the given function is g of x, which is equal to 8x cube minus 6x square minus 2x plus 1, and which is nothing but the polynomial function of third degree. And it's obvious that the polynomial functions, composite functions, and composite exponential and trigonometrical functions are always continuous. So therefore g of x, the 8x cube minus 6x square minus 2x plus 1 is always continuous, right? Now going to the differentiability of the function, differentiability of the function, for that you take the derivative of the given function. The derivative of the given function is nothing but 24x square minus 12x minus 2, and which does not give any indeterminate or infinite value at whatever point x. Here the interval is 0 comma 1, therefore it is always differentiable. And third, we'll show that the f of a is equal to f of b. F of 0 is equal to 1, and f of 1 is equal to, and f of 1 is also equal to 8 minus 6 minus 2 plus 1, which is always again 0. So f of 0 is equal to f of 1. The three conditions are satisfied. Therefore the using of this Rolle's mean value theorem is right. So we'll try to find out the c such that f dash of c is equal to 0, where f dash is in nothing but 24x square minus 12x minus 2, so which is nothing but 24c square minus 12c minus 2 is equal to 0, where c is equal to 1 plus r minus 2, 21 by 2. Among this we'll take the value which is light, because here we have two c values, but the interval is 0 comma 1, so in between this interval we can find only one value, that is 0.63. therefore c is equal to 0.63 lies inside the interval 0 comma 1. Therefore hence there exists at least one root between 0 comma 1. So this is how we can make use of the Rolle's theorem. And even this is also the another example, x to the power of 2 by 3 and 2x to the power of 1 by 3. Okay, So here even this function is also continuous and differentiable, and both the end points are same, so we can apply the mean value theorem and find out the c value, and we will get the c value as 1, which lies between 0 and 8. So in that way we can apply the Rolle's theorem. So these are all the examples of Rolle's mean value theorem. Here the product of algebraic and exponential function is given, x into x plus 3 e to e power minus x by 2. We have to verify too. So we have to, when you want to verify, we need to check the continuity, differentiability, and the both the end points. So all the end points, and find out c such that if suppose if you are getting more than one c value, you search for the point where at least one point it lies between the given interval. Okay, so 0 comma minus 3. So minus 2 is a point here which lies between minus 3 comma 0. Hence the Rolle's mean value theorem is verified. Okay, so this is how we can check the mean value theorems. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.